March 21, 2024, we're at the World Health Organization. I'm here with Thomas Cueni from, Thomas, could you introduce yourself, tell people who you are, who you represent, why you're here in the negotiations, how you think things are going, and what advice you have for the negotiators?
I'm Thomas Cueni. I'm Director General of IFPMA, representing the world's innovative companies, which accounted for most of the vaccines and treatments used against COVID-19. I'm here because after more than 2 years negotiations of the Intergovernmental Negotiating Body, it's literally the first time that the INB arranges an open session with stakeholders and wants to listen to us on what are critical issues of the pandemic accord negotiation and the pathogen access benefit sharing.
Do you have advice for the negotiators?
I think my concern is we really need to learn from what we experienced through COVID. And when we look at COVID, innovation in science delivered at record speed and scale. And it delivered because we were able to rely on a very effective innovation ecosystem. We also benefited from immediate access, free access to pathogens and genetic sequence. We need to preserve what worked well, and we need to fix what didn't work well, namely the rollout of vaccines in particular was inequitable. Therefore, we really need to focus on addressing the equity problem.
Is there anything that surprised you this week in terms of the negotiation?
Not really. I think we are at a rather critical stage and we are concerned because when I look at the texts which are on the table from the Bureau of the INB, they would not preserve what worked well. They would compromise, you know, the ability of scientists to respond so quickly. They would compromise the free access to pathogens. And when I look at colleagues of manufacturers from developing countries, they agree with us. We really need to fix the equity problem. We need to make sure that access to pathogens and genetic sequences remains free and is not monetized. And we need to work together on equitable rollout. We have in 2022 come up with the Berlin Declaration where companies committed themselves to putting aside part of production for medical need-based rollout by WHO or any of the other organizations in charge. We have teamed up with the developing country vaccine manufacturers on that. This commitment was renewed a week ago, and we added an element which is important. Companies are willing to mandatory binding commitments in terms of sharing medical countermeasures. And I must say I'm concerned that there are now so many barriers in the text which would disincentivize rather than induce companies to join. I hope that at the end of the day common sense prevails because we are interested in an agreement. We also interested the interest of public health prevails and there one needs to be pragmatic and not dogmatic.
Thank you very much. Before I turn off the video, is there anything, last thing you'd like to add?
Pragmatism and the reality check is needed.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Jamie.